Hi, I'm Seth. Welcome to Review. Nice to have you today. Today we're going to review Halloween. Halloween stars Jamie Lee Curtis as Laurie Strode, Judy Greer as her daughter Karen, and Andy Menachek as Laurie's granddaughter Addison. Halloween is one of the best horror franchises of all time. The concept is simple. Three things. Psychopath, teenage babysitters, and Halloween night. And psychopath murdering teenage babysitters on Halloween night. Very simple. Very effective. This version of Halloween is better than the last few sequels, and it pays homage to the original, which you can see throughout the movie. The movie starts when two podcasters from England bring their podcast to Smith's Grove to do a true crime episode on Michael Myers and Laurie Strode 40 years later. They present Michael with a mask. He immediately goes berserk, and later that night, he escapes from Smith's Grove to go on a rampage that mirrors his first rampage in 1978. The years have not been kind to Laurie Strode. She's traumatized with her meeting with Michael Myers and 1978. Now this movie is meant to be Halloween 2 or something, because they're just disavowing all the other Halloween, Halloween H2O, Halloween 3, and they're just taking it like Michael Myers has been in Smith's Grove since November 1978. So there's no sequel or backstory that they manufactured for some of the sequels. It's just 1978 and now. Laurie Strode is paranoid and spends all of her waking hours trying to keep her family safe by putting lights and motion trackers in the yard. She even has a panic room installed under her kitchen. All these obsessions in her life have driven a wedge between her and her daughter Karen and her granddaughter Addison. Karen is the opposite of Laurie. She walks around like everything's fine and the world is safe and nothing's gonna harm her. Addison, on the other hand, is a lot like her grandmother. She's very cautious, very upfront and protective. Addison wants the family to be safe, and she wants the family to be united again. It's interesting to see how these different dysfunctional family roles work in Halloween. It gives the characters more authenticity because the pain doesn't go away after the trauma is over. Like, Laurie Strode is never going to forget Michael Myers, never going to forget what happened that night in 1978. And she's going to carry it with her, and she's probably really going to be this protective person going, I don't want this to ever happen to my family again. Another interesting thing is that there are no wasted characters in this film. This is different from a normal slasher film because the victims are two-dimensional. They're like Skittles, you know, you eat one and just you don't even care. You're just spending Skittles and they don't mean anything. They're just a prop to drive the movie forward. Killing, killing, killing. And here's where another change comes in. This Halloween is laced with dark humor from the more minor characters. you know, everyone knows that Halloween happened 40 years ago, and they're all cracking jokes about it. Also, like I alluded to before, the pacing is much faster in this Halloween than in the original Halloween. When Michael Myers gets out, he doesn't stop killing. He seems to enjoy it, even though you never see his face under his mask. There's no explanation as to why he kills. Michael Myers is a force of nature. The wind blows, Michael Myers kills. There are also more kills in this Halloween, some of them on screen and some of them off. Slasher fans will like the on-screen kills, but I think that the off-screen kills, for me, were scarier because I have an overactive imagination and probably shouldn't be watching too many horror films. You're going to like this film whether or not you've kept up with the sequels or if this is your first time. Like all classic horror movies, this is a late movie because the object of a horror movie, at least for the audience, is you bring in... I don't know why I have to explain this, but the object of a horror movie is you bring your name so you can get a little closer to him or her because, you know, it kind of breaks the ice. That's the whole point of it from my perspective. If you like this film, click like, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications, visit my links in the comment box below, and I really thank you for visiting me today. It means a lot to me, and I'll see you in the next movie review.